Hi, I'm Erica Gamet with InDesign Secrets. In this video, I'm going to show you how to place an image into your InDesign document. When you place anything into InDesign, you use the same command, and that's the Place command. It's up here under the File menu, under Place. You can also use the keyboard shortcuts Command or Control D. I'll click Place, and it brings up the Place dialog box. You can navigate to wherever your images are sitting. A couple of options I want to look at before we import anything is down at the bottom, we have a replace selected item already selected. I want to deselect that because what that does is it will put the image that we choose into whatever we have selected on our page. And if you're like me, you may have forgotten you've got something selected on another page. Also, we can click Show Import Options. Selecting this option will bring up a second dialog box where we get to choose options. Now, we won't have many available to us in this case, but depending on what you're importing, you may want to have that turned on. So I've selected that. I'm going to go ahead and just select an image and click Open. And because we had those options selected, it came up with a second dialog box. And as you can see, most of my options are grayed out. I'm going to leave everything as is and just click OK. Now we have our loaded place cursor. And this is just the image ready to be placed. We have a couple different options for actually placing this image onto our document. I can simply just click and let it place the image to size on my page. And as I can see, that runs off the right and the bottom of my page. I can't even see the edges of the photo. So that's probably not the best option. I'm going to undo that, Command or Control Z, and get back to my loaded place cursor. A better option is to click and drag while holding down the mouse button, and it will drag out a frame to the size that it needs. It will also maintain the orientation and the proportions of your original image. When you've got it to size, simply let go, and the image is placed inside that frame. I'm going to take another step backwards, Command or Control Z to undo, get back to my loaded place cursor, because sometimes you want a frame that's a different orientation than your original image. To do that, I need to use the Shift key. I'm going to click and start to drag and then hit the Shift key. And now I can play with the proportions of that frame that I'm drawing out. When I have the size I want and the shape I want, I'm going to just let go of the mouse key. I'm still holding down the Shift key while I'm doing this at the moment. As you can see, the frame is the size I wanted it to be, but the image doesn't fill up the frame like I had hoped. A quick fix for this is to go up to the Object menu, down to the Fitting menu, and choose Fill Frame Proportionally. Now the image completely fills the frame that I created. From here, you'll probably have to make more adjustments to the image and the frame, but we'll cover that in more detail in a future video. Now, when you go to place your image, you may already have a frame on your page and have it selected, and you want the image to go directly into that. With that image selected, we're going to go back to the Place menu, File, Place, choose that same image, but we're going to make sure that we click Replace Selected Item. I'm also going to turn off Show Import Options. If this is deselected, it will automatically use the options you chose last time. So I'm going to deselect that and click Open, and it automatically dropped that image into that particular frame. I'm going to step backwards again, hit Undo, Command or Control Z, and hit Escape so I get my loaded place cursor gone. I just want to go back to the point where I had this frame selected. I have it selected, go up to the File menu, choose Place, and maybe we have that Replace Selected Item turned off, because again, that's a good safety feature to not have that on. So I have that off, select my image and start to place it, and I realize I really did want to put that image inside that frame. It's no big deal. I can just roll over that image, and it's really hard to see, I know, but when you do that, the little brackets around that place cursor icon become these rounded brackets. And when I do that, it says, oh, you must want to put that image inside that frame. So simply roll over it and click, and the image goes inside that frame. And lastly, let's say you already have an empty frame and you don't intend to put that image inside there. We do the same place command, File, Place. I'm going to choose that same image and click Open. And we drag it out and we think that's good. Then we realize we really wanted it inside this existing frame. I can do that as well without having to replace it. I just need to select the image that I've placed, copy it, Command or Control C, or I can cut it, Command or Control X, select the empty frame, go up under the Edit menu, and choose Paste Into. Now that image is sitting inside that frame. Well, I certainly hope you found this tip helpful. Be sure to check out InDesignSecrets.com for thousands of InDesign articles and tutorials, and to subscribe to our monthly publication, InDesign Magazine. Thanks for learning with us.